A very good morning to all of you. Today, the topic of discussion is Boolean algebra. In this topic, we will discuss postulates of Boolean algebra, theorems of Boolean algebra, and simplifications of Boolean functions. So let's start with our first topic, that is, what is Boolean algebra and what are the postulates of Boolean algebra? What is Boolean algebra basically? Boolean algebra may be defined with a set of elements, a set of operators, and a number of unproved axioms or postulates. In Boolean algebra, we are having three things. One is set of elements. Second is your set of operators. And third is your postulates. What do you mean by postulates? Postulates are nothing but true facts. The set of elements which we use in Boolean algebra is AND, OR, and NOT. The symbol for AND is dot, the symbol for OR is plus, and the symbol for NOT is negation, which is represented by a tilde symbol. The Boolean algebra was developed in 1854 by an English mathematician known as George Boole. Let's start with postulates of Boolean algebra. Postulates of Boolean algebra. There are six postulates of Boolean algebra. Boolean algebra postulates was developed in 1904 by Huntington. The first postulate of Boolean algebra is closure property. This property says for every a comma b belongs to S, the elements a comma b belongs to set S, then if we do AND operation, if we do OR operation, that also belongs to set, and if we do AND operation, that also belongs to set. The second property is your existence of identity element. According to this property, there is a set which consists of an element A. If A plus 0 is always equals to A, A dot 1 equals to A. According to existence of identity, A is an element which belongs to set S. Therefore, we can say A plus 0 equals to A, A dot 1 equals to A. The third postulate which we want to remember is that is commutative law. A and B are two elements which belongs to set S such that A dot B equals to B dot A. This is my first. And second is A plus B is always equals to B plus A. The fourth postulate which we have to remember is distributive law. A, B, C are the three elements which belongs to set S such that A dot B plus C is equals to A dot B plus A dot C, and second, A plus B dot C is equals to a plus b dot a plus c. These are the postulates of Boolean algebra. The next postulate of Boolean algebra is law of complementary. This is the fifth postulate, law of complementary. According to this law, A, B, C are the three elements which belongs to set S, such that A plus A bar equals to 1, A dot A bar equals to 0. And the last postulate is, there are at least two elements which A comma B, which belongs to set S, such that A will never be equals to B. These are the six postulates which we will use while simplifying the Boolean algebra. The six postulates are, I repeat, first is your closure property. Second postulate is your existence of identity. The third postulate is your commutative law. The fourth postulate is your distributive law. The fifth postulate is law of complementary. And the last postulate is A and B are the two elements which belongs to set S, such that A will never be equals to B. These are the six postulates of Boolean algebra. The next topic which we are going to discuss is theorems of Boolean algebra. The next topic of discussion is theorems of Boolean algebra. The first theorem which we will discuss is idempotent law. Idempotent law says A plus A is always equals to A. Let's prove this law. Left hand side is A plus A. According to existence of identity, A dot 1 is equals to A. According to existence of identity, A dot 1 is always equals to A. Consider this term whole as A. So I can say that A plus A dot 1, this is A. A ko beta main aise likh sakti hu, A dot 1. To maine isko likha A plus A dot 1. इसको मैंने पूरा कंप्लीट ए कंसीडर किया है तो आई कैन राइट इट ए डॉट वन. अकॉर्डिंग टू कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री लॉ, ए प्लस ए बार इज इक्वल्स टू वन. तो वन को मैं कैसे लिख सकती हूं बेटा, ए प्लस ए डॉट ए प्लस ए बार. According to distributive law, A plus B dot C is equals to A plus B डॉट ए प्लस सी। तो इस चीज को बेटा मैं कैसे लिख सकती हूँ, ऐसे लिख सकती हूँ, कंसीडर दिस एज ए, कंसीडर दिस एज बी, इसको कंसीडर करो ए, इसको कंसीडर करो सी। बेटा ये यही चीज बन रही है, दिस इज ए प्लस बी एंड दिस इज ए प्लस सी। आई कैन राइट इट एज दिस, तो इसको मैं कैसे लिखूंगी बेटा, दैट इज ए प्लस ए प्लस ए बार। क्लियर, अकॉर्डिंग टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव लॉ। एंड आई नो अकॉर्डिंग टू कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री लॉ ए प्लस ए बार इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू वन, तो ए प्लस वन। क्लियर, ए प्लस इट्स डॉट, तो ए डॉट ए इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू जीरो, तो दिस इज जीरो, तो ए प्लस जीरो इज ऑलवेज ए, तो देयरफॉर आई कैन से माय लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इज इक्वल टू राइट हैंड साइड, हेंस प्रूव्ड। यही बेटा मुझे प्रूफ करना था, ए प्लस ए किसके इक्वल होता है, ए के इक्वल होता है, तो दिस इज माय आइडेम्पोटेंट लॉ। अब एक चीज और देखो, इन आइडेम्पोटेंट लॉ देयर इज वन प्रिंसिपल विच इज नोन एज प्रिंसिप ड्यूअलिटी प्रिंसिपल, ड्यूअलिटी प्रिंसिपल। अकॉर्डिंग टू ड्यूअलिटी प्रिंसिपल आई कैन इंटरचेंज डॉट विद प्लस एंड प्लस विद डॉट, सेकेंड आई कैन इंटरचेंज जीरो विद वन एंड वन विद जीरो, तो देयरफॉर ए प्लस ए इक्वल्स टू ए, बेटा ये अभी प्रूफ करा है, तो अकॉर्डिंग टू ड्यूअलिटी ऑफ प्रिंसिपल ए डॉट ए इज ऑलवेज इक्वल्स टू ए, अकॉर्डिंग टू ड्यूअलिटी ऑफ प्रिंसिपल। बिकॉज अभी मैंने आपको क्या बोला कि आप प्लस को इंटरचेंज कर सकते हो डॉट से, डॉट को इंटरचेंज कर सकते हो प्लस से, तो मैंने वही किया है, प्लस को इंटरचेंज किया है डॉट से और डॉट को इंटरचेंज किया है मैंने प्लस से, तो दिस थ्योरम ऑल्सो एग्जिस्ट। क्लियर, तो नेक्स्ट थ्योरम जो अब हमने पढ़नी है दैट इज एब्जॉर्प्शन लॉ। द नेक्स्ट थ्योरम विच वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इज एब्जॉर्प्शन लॉ। एब्जॉर्प्शन लॉ सेज ए प्लस ए डॉट बी इक्वल्स टू ए, लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इज ए प्लस ए डॉट बी। अकॉर्डिंग टू एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ आइडेंटिटी, अपना पॉस्टुलेट चेक करो, अकॉर्डिंग टू एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ आइडेंटिटी ए डॉट वन इज ऑलवेज इक्वल्स टू ए, तो आई कैन राइट इट एज ए डॉट वन प्लस ए डॉट बी। अकॉर्डिंग टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव लॉ, ए डॉट बी प्लस सी इज ऑलवेज इक्वल्स टू ए डॉट बी प्लस ए डॉट सी। बेटा मेरे पास यही चीज इधर आ रही है, दिस इज ए, दिस इज बी, दिस इज ए एंड दिस इज सी, तो आई कैन राइट इट एज ए डॉट बी प्लस सी, तो इट विल बी ए डॉट वन प्लस बी अकॉर्डिंग टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव लॉ। अकॉर्डिंग टू कॉम्यूटेटिव लॉ आई कैन से ए डॉट बी इक्वल्स टू बी डॉट ए, और आई कैन से ए प्लस बी इक्वल्स टू बी प्लस सी, देयरफॉर आई कैन राइट वन प्लस बी इक्वल्स टू बी प्लस वन, तो ए डॉट बी प्लस वन अकॉर्डिंग टू कॉम्यूटेटिव लॉ। देयर इज वन थ्योरम ए प्लस वन इक्वल्स टू वन, a plus 1 equals to 1. By using this theorem, I can also say b plus 1 is always equals to 1. So therefore, a dot 1 is always equals to a according to existence of identity. Therefore, left hand side is equals to right hand side, hence proved. Clear? This is my first absorption law. Now we will discuss second absorption law. Before discussing the second absorption law, I would like to tell you that according to duality of principle, I can interchange dot with plus and plus with dot, and second, I can interchange 0 with 1 and 1 with 0. The first absorption law say a plus a dot b equals to a. So according to duality of principle, I can say that a dot a plus b is also equals to a. This theorem also exists. According to duality of principle. Next, we will discuss second absorption law. According to second absorption law, a plus a bar dot b is equals to a plus b. Clear? So let's prove this thing. This is my left hand side, a plus a bar dot b. According to complementary law, I have studied a plus a bar is always equals to 1. Clear? And according to distributive law, a plus b dot c is equals to a plus b and a plus c. Beta, I have to apply distributive law here. This is my a, this is my b, and this is my c. So if I apply distributive law, so I can write it like this. That is a plus a bar a plus b. Now according to complementary law, I know a plus a bar is equals to 1. So 1 a plus b, 1 dot a plus b. A 1 dot a plus b, again I have to apply distributive law here. So it will be 1 plus a, 1 plus b. According to commutative law, a plus b is equals to b plus a. Therefore, I can say 1 plus a equals to a plus 1 and 1 plus b equals to b plus 1. So therefore, 1 plus a ko hum kaise likhenge? A plus 1 and 1 plus b ko I can write b plus 1. Clear? There is one theorem, a plus 1 equals to 1. So therefore, the value is 1 and one theorem. This is a dot. So I can write it as a dot 1, b dot 1. So a dot 1, according to existence of identity, the value is a. So I can write a. Aise hi b dot 1, the value is b. So I can write it as b. Hence proved. Left hand side is equals to right hand side. This is my second absorption law. Now, according to duality of principle, My second absorption law is A plus A bar dot B equals to A plus B. According to duality principle, I can say A dot A bar plus B equals to A dot B. So this is my second absorption law. Now we will discuss next theorem, that is your third absorption law. Third absorption law says A dot A plus B plus C equals to A. The left hand side, A dot A plus B plus C. According to distributive law, I can say that A dot B plus C is equals to A plus B. A dot B plus A dot C, and A plus B dot C is equals to A plus B dot A plus C. According to distributive law, consider it as A. इसको कंसीडर करो बी एंड कंसीडर एट सी. तो ए डॉट बी प्लस सी को हम कैसे लिख सकते हैं, ए डॉट बी प्लस ए डॉट सी. तो ए डॉट बी, दैट इज दिस, प्लस ए डॉट सी, ए डॉट सी. अब अकॉर्डिंग टू फर्स्ट एब्जॉर्प्शन लॉ, आई नो दैट ए डॉट ए प्लस बी इज इक्वल्स टू ए. तो हम इसको क्या बोलेंगे, ए प्लस ए डॉट सी. अकॉर्डिंग टू फर्स्ट एब्जॉर्प्शन लॉ, I can also say that A dot A plus C is equals to A. So therefore, I can write it as A. Therefore, left hand side is equals to your right hand side, hence proved. If this theorem exists according to duality of principle, A plus A dot B dot C equals to A. According to duality of principle, I can also say that A plus A dot B dot C is equals to A. This is my third absorption law. The next theorem which we are going to discuss is involution law. The next theorem is involution law. According to involution law, A double bar is always equals to A. So in this we will consider two cases to prove this theorem. One is your case 1 and second is your case 2. In case 1, I assume A equals to 0. And in case 2, I assume A equals to 1. Taking complement both side. So A bar is equals to 0 bar. The complement of 0 is 1. Therefore, A bar equals to 1. Taking complement both side. Again, A double bar equals to 1 bar. Complement of 1 is 0. Therefore, A double bar equals to 0. And I also know A equals to 0. So instead of 0, I can write A. So hence proved, a double bar equals to a. Now consider this case also. Taking complement, both side a bar equals to 1 bar, the complement of 1 is 0. Taking complement, both side a double bar equals to 0 bar, the complement of 0 is 1. So I can say a double bar equals to 1, and I also know that a equals to 1. So instead of a, I can write a. Hence proved. A double bar is always equals to a. मतलब a double complement is always equals to a. This is my neck involution law. The last theorem which we will discuss is De Morgan's law. The De Morgan's law says a plus b whole complement equals to a bar dot b bar, and a bar dot b whole complement equals to a bar plus b bar. So let's prove this with the help of truth table. I have to prove a plus b bar equals to a bar dot b bar. How many variables are there? There exist two variables. So therefore 2 raised to power 2 equals to 4. So 4 conditions are possible. So I have written a, b, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. First of all, I have to calculate a plus b. Plus ka matlab kya hota hai? Or. तो और का ट्रूथ टेबल कंसीडर करेंगे. टू इनपुट्स है मेरे पास, तो आउटपुट मेरे पास क्या आएगी बेटा? जीरो जीरो आई विल गेट जीरो, जीरो वन आई विल गेट वन, वन जीरो आई विल गेट वन, एंड वन वन आई विल गेट वन. तो दिस इज द ट्रूथ टेबल ऑफ और. जीरो 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 वन वन, वन जीरो वन, वन वन वन. नाउ आई हैव टू टेक द कॉम्प्लीमेंट ऑफ ए प्लस बी बार. दैट विल बी 0 complement will be 1, 1's complement will be 0. So this is my left hand side. Clear? Now I have to calculate right hand side. So a bar. A bar ka matlab a's ka complement. So that will be 1, 1, 0, 0. Now calculate b complement. B complement will be 1, 0, 1, 0. I have to calculate a bar dot b bar. Dot means AND operation. So I have to use AND truth table. I am having two inputs, that is X, Y, and I will get an output here. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, I will get 1. So 1, 1, I will get 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. This is my right hand side. Now see that your left hand side is equals to right hand side. Left hand side is equals to right hand side. Therefore, hence proved. We can say that a plus b bar is equals to a bar dot b bar. Clear? This theorem also exists. How we can prove this? According to duality of principle. मैंने क्या किया बेटा? प्लस को इंटरचेंज किससे कर दिया? डॉट से. और डॉट को इंटरचेंज किससे कर दिया? प्लस से. तो हेंस प्रूव्ड. तो दीज ऑल आर द थ्योरम्स विच वी आर गोइंग टू यूज व्हाइल परफॉर्मिंग बूलियन सिंप्लीफिकेशन ऑफ बूलियन फंक्शंस. तो बेटा जब भी मुझे सिंप्लीफिकेशन करनी है, द थर्ड टॉपिक विच आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस इज सिंप्लीफिकेशन ऑफ बूलियन फंक्शन. सिंप्लीफिकेशन ऑफ बूलियन फंक्शन. तो व्हेन एवर वी वॉन्ट टू डू सिंप्लीफिकेशन, आई हैव टू यूज पोस्टुलेट्स which we have discussed earlier, and theorems. Without this topic, simplification is not possible. Let's consider one example of simplification. The question is x bar y bar plus x y. I have to simplify using the postulates and theorem. So how I will do x bar y bar plus in dono terms mein se I have to take x common. What will be left inside? 1 plus y. Clear? There is one theorem, 1 plus y equals to 1. Okay? 1 plus y equals to 1. So instead of 1 plus y, I put value that is 1. So x bar y bar plus x. According to commutative law, a plus b equals to b plus a. Therefore, x bar y bar plus x equals to x plus x bar y bar. So instead of this, I can write it as like this, x plus x bar y bar according to commutative law. According to distributive law, postulates mein humne padha tha, according to distributive law, I know that a plus bc is equals to a plus b, a plus c. So I can write it like this. This is a plus bc. I can write it as a plus b, a plus c. According to complementary law, a plus a bar is always equals to 1. So therefore, x plus x bar is always equals to 1. So 1 dot x plus y bar. According to distributive law, 1 dot x plus 1 dot y bar. According to complementary law, a dot 1 is equals to a. Therefore, 1 dot x is all equals to x and 1 dot y bar is equals to y bar. Therefore, x plus y bar, this is the answer. You can also apply commutative law here also. According to commutative law, a dot b is equals to b dot a. So therefore, 1 dot x equals to x dot 1 and 1 dot y bar is equals to y bar dot 1. So it will be x dot 1 plus y bar dot 1. Now you can apply here the property according to existence of identity, a dot 1 is always equals to 1. Therefore, 1 dot x equals to x and 1, x dot 1 equals to x, y bar dot 1 equals to y bar. So, maine yahi yahan par put kiya hai and this is your answer. In this way, we can simplify the Boolean functions. There are some questions of Boolean functions which we will discuss in next class. For more queries,